I am Habib Başkör. I am currently a master's student in computer science program at Boğaziçi University. My advisors are Emre Uren and Cihan. I will present a study entitled A Computational Model of Event Segmentation and Learning. This is the structure of my talk. What is event segmentation? Our experience is composed of events. The person in the animation reads book, works in front of a computer, and walks in a public garden. Each event corresponds to different action dynamics. Event segmentation is the ability to segment an activity into meaningful units. Event segmentation is studied with a simple paradigm called unitization developed by Netson. He asked people to find meaningful events in a movie by pressing a button and observe where people's segment is similar. These points are called event breakpoints. There is an important property of event segmentation, which is segmentation granularity. It refers to the fact that people can segment activity in different granularities. Event segmentation theory explains how people segment. This is the information processing model of event segmentation theory. Event models are working memory representations. They bias our sensory processing and generate perception. With the help of them, we make perceptual predictions. Perceptual predictions might generate prediction errors that are monitored by the system. If the error shows a transient increase, an error-based gating mechanism is closed, and event breakpoint is detected. Then, with the current sensory observation, we search for another event model in our memory. Our proposed model is based on event segmentation theory and predictive coding. We improve the capacity of a computational model developed by Gunch et al. Our proposed computational model can learn data points in nonlinear and complex data, and segment a nonlinear and complex sequence of information. The model developed by Gunch et al. Is not able to learn and segment events in this way. Our method can segment events through passive observation. The model developed by Gunch et al. Grants events on sensory motor processes. For this reason, it needs motoric action. Additionally, our method considers all types of sensory inputs together. For this reason, it can detect relationship between different types of sensory inputs in learning and segmenting events. These are our contributions to the literature. We take behavior from KIT motion language dataset. To represent events, we use X and Y positions of 14 markers. The sequence is normalized and the FPS rate is reduced from 120 to 12. The figure below represents X and Y trajectories of points. We give this sequence to our method for segmentation and learning. Event models are multilayer perceptrons in our method and they try to predict change in X and Y positions of points in this application. The current event models receive sensory observation and predict sensory change. Predicting sensory change might generate a prediction error. The error is monitored by the system and accumulated. And a threshold rate named surprise threshold is calculated for each event model. This rate is calculated by the rolling mean of errors and the rolling mean of the standard deviation of errors. This formula has a parameter named theta that determines how much we can be confident about our event models. If the current error exceeds this threshold rate, this means that unexpected sensory observation occurs for the current event model. In the search period, the surprise sensory input is tried to be assimilated by training with event models that the system already has. If it cannot be assimilated, then a new event model is formed to accommodate the new experience. By this method, we can segment a nonlinear and complex sequence and assign these segments into different multilayer perceptrons. The figure shows how good our event models are in predicting sensory change. The solid line shows real sensory change, whereas the dashed line shows predictions of event models. Recall that more than one event model is generated for the sequence. In this slide, I will show the movement and how our method segmented it. Recall that the behavior is defined as a person picks up an object and places it on a surface in front of him in the dataset. The red line shows X and Y positions of points. In this figure, you can see errors and surprise threshold rates of event models. This red marker shows dashed lines that represent frames at which event models change. These frames are called as event breakpoints. The marker shows assigned event models to sequences. This red marker shows when the system goes to search period to assimilate the sensory input with event models or accommodate it by forming a new event model. These two figures show absolute changes in X and Y trajectories of points. In addition to the segmentation results, we check whether event segment detected by our method is meaningful. You can see possible interpretations of event segments from the table. In this study, we propose a computational model of event segmentation and learning. In the future, we will consider constant events with the same method by changing the event threshold parameter, and we are going to assess the results of our model with the ground truth. Our study shows that the event segmentation theory gives a plausible mechanism for event segmentation. Thanks for listening.